7 national championships, 23 bowl championships, and 38 conference titles. The 2002 Oklahoma Sooners once again proving to be among the elite of college football, culminating with a third consecutive January bowl game win and a top five finish in the national polls. The Sooner season started with a trip across I-44 in Tulsa at Skelly Stadium against the Golden Hurricane. 9 Sooners making their first career starts for the number one ranked Crimson and Cream in front of mostly OU faithful. Oklahoma with 2 turnovers in the red zone in the first half led just 3-0 heading into halftime, thanks to a 44-yard field goal by true freshman Trey DiCarlo. The second half was a whole different story. Quentin Griffin, who rushed for a career-high 237 yards on the day, found some daylight early in the half.
There's a handoff. Griffin up the middle. Big haul, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40, down the sideline, 30, 25, 20, and pushed out of bounds. At the 19-yard line, great block by Will Peoples.
Jenks native Keewon Jones would then find the end zone.
Touchdown, Oklahoma. Great blocking on the left side. As Keewon Jones spurt, boom, through the left side.
Later in the quarter, OU would find a weapon that would prove deadly to their opponents all year long.
Fine to the 10, and a 51-yard kick to the 20, to the 25, 30. Oh, what a great run to the 40. He could go all the way. 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 20, 15, 10. He slows down and just waltzes into the end zone. An incredible 91-yard punt return for Antonio Perkins.
Antonio Perkins' 91-yard punt return for 6, the third longest in school history, had OU rolling. The Sooners tacked on 3 fourth-quarter touchdowns, rolling up 421 yards on the ground, recording their second consecutive shutout over TU, 37-0. The 2002 home opener at Oklahoma Memorial Stadium was a matchup of arguably 2 of the greatest programs in college football history. OU hosting the Crimson Tide of Alabama, the first of 7 appearances the Sooners would make on ABC in 2002. The Tide quickly grabbed a 3-0 lead, then found out just how special OU's special teams were.
Ball down, kick, block, and a pileup in the middle of the field. So it'll be at the 33-yard line. Oklahoma recovers. He fumbled the ball, goes all the way back. It's into the end zone, and the kicker kicks it out of the end zone for a safety.
OU still trailed 3-2 when Jason White, trying to come back from last year's torn ACL, connected with Mark Clayton.
Touchdown, Oklahoma!
The Sooners led 9-3, but unfortunately, that would be the last completion of 2002 for the Tuttle Jr. Jason White would be lost for the season after tearing the ACL in his other knee. The Sooners, who were ranked 10th nationally in turnover margin, forced 4 on the day.
Fumble, and Oklahoma says they got it. They do.
Senior Nate Hibble wasted little time capitalizing on the miscue.
Hibble back to pass. He looked. He throws a long, long pass for Clayton downfield. Caught the 50, 10, 5, touchdown, Oklahoma, I believe. Yes. A 51-yard touchdown pass.
Just before half, Hibble did it himself. 23-3, OU was rolling at the break. Alabama scored 24 unanswered points to take a 27-23 fourth quarter lead. OU then turned to what works best. Ronaldo works coming up with 2 spectacular efforts, bringing the Sooners all the way down to the Alabama 8-yard line. That set the stage for some more Sooner magic.
Here's the handle. He won down the 5-2-1. Touchdown, Oklahoma! Right down the middle.
The Oklahoma defense sent the record crowd of 75,564 home happy.
Shotgun, back to pass. He's hit, fumbles it, and the Sooners pick it up and run into the 35-30. The Spassy to the 15, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma!
Oklahoma 37, Alabama 27. The Sooners improving to 2-0. Oklahoma hosted UTEP in their next contest, and the Sooners were not too kind to their Texas neighbors. OU scoring on 11 of 16 possessions in the game. In fact, the only thing to slow OU down this night was a 51-minute rain and lightning delay.
Pretty good protection. Throws a long pass upfield. Intercepted at the 50-yard line. 45-40. That's Perkins. Antonio to the 30, to the 25-20, 15. To his left to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma. A 50-yard interception return. Offset eye. Hibble under center. Tight end on the right side. Reverse is fake. Hibble throws a pass. Has a man wide open. 5-yard line. Touchdown. Ronaldo works. Beautiful play. Reynolds in the backfield. Kewan Jones. Pitch to Jones. Right side. 5-1. Touchdown. Hand off to Griffin over left. Tackle breaks down in the middle. 25. 20. Goes left. 15. Goes to the 10. Needs a block. At the 5. Touchdown. What a great run by Griffin. That is a 29-yard run from inches away. The turn to give to Kewan. Touchdown, Oklahoma. He dove over Mike Skinner and Vince Carter. Shotgun. Paul Thompson hands the ball off to Griffin. Down the middle. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Three-step drop with the pass. He is intercepted. 35. Down to the 30. 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. Michael Hawkins. True freshman from Carrollton, Texas. R.L. Turner.
The Sooner D forced 5 turnovers on the way to a 68-0 shutout over the Miners. A date with the South Florida Bulls was next on the Sooner schedule. South Florida, which won 8 regular season games in 2002, kept the game scoreless into the second quarter. Things changed quickly thanks to the legs of Antonio Perkins.
20, back to his right, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. He's at 50, may go all the way. 45, 40, a flag is down as he goes all the way in for the touchdown. And let's see if it's on South Florida or on the Sooners. They mob Antonio Perkins, who made a tremendous return. He was not touched, I don't believe.
AP's second punt return for a TD in 4 games was the first of 3 Sooners scores in the quarter.
Nate Hibble turn, fakes, throws a lob pass, caught, touchdown Oklahoma. J.D. Reynolds for Hibble, pump fakes, now going deep. And Peoples makes a great catch, touchdown Oklahoma. What a great catch by Will Peoples, who stretched out the length of his body.
South Florida scored 2 late touchdowns, breaking up OU's bid for a 3rd shutout of the season. Junior college transfer Lance Mitchell made his presence known, recording 10 tackles on the day, including 3 for losses in a 31-14 win. Oklahoma was off to a 4-0 start. After losing 2001 All-Americans Roy Williams and Rocky Kalmus to the NFL, the 2002 Sooner defense proved to everyone to be perhaps even better than last year's squad, forcing 13 turnovers in the first 4 games.
Here comes the boys from the south.
handoff. Pretty good protection. Throws a long pass upfield. Intercepted at the 50-yard line. 45-40. And Perkins. Antonio to the 30. To the 25-20. 50. To the 10. To the 10. To the 5. Touchdown. Here's a long, long pass downfield. Intercepted with a great kickoff. Andre Wolfolk with a tremendous interception.
The Sooner defense would be tested in Columbia against the Missouri Tigers and freshman quarterback Brad Smith. Just like the Bama game, OU opened up a big lead. Nate Hibble threw for 303 yards, including a 65-yard strike to Curtis Fagan.
Pass caught. Smith at the 40, 45-50. Fagan, 45-40, 35-30, the 25-20, 15 to the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma!
Quentin Griffin began his amazing streak of 10 straight 100-yard games, picking up 103 against Mizzou.
He gets away from tackle. He's at the 50. He's at the 45-40, 35-30, 25-20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma!
Q's run had OU up 23-7 midway through the third quarter. Brad Smith led the Tigers back. His 25-yard scramble put MU up by a point with 10 minutes remaining. Smith rushed for 213 yards, the first Sooner opponent to top the 200-yard mark in 37 games. Linebacker Lance Mitchell had 19 tackles on the day. His last shook Brad Smith up a bit. The very next play, Brandon Everidge made a great play picking off the freshman quarterback. Still, Bob Stoops needed to reach into his bag of tricks for yet another piece of Sooner magic.
Angle to the right. Fake. Here's the look, a flop pass to the end zone, and touchdown Oklahoma! And it's a great play, Chris Chester.
I just tried to get a good release and get my guy off me and went up there and just made the grab.
Number two Oklahoma survives 31-24 at Faurot Field, improving to 5-0, setting up another classic Red River War. In the 97th edition of the OU-Texas Red River Shootout, both teams came in ranked tied for second in the ESPN USA Today coaches poll. As always, a crimson trail was marked from Norman to Dallas all the way down I-35. The Horns, trying to erase two straight years of frustration at the hands of the Sooners, grabbed a 14-3 lead thanks to Rod Baber's 73-yard interception return. In the game, Nate Hibble was intercepted for the first time in 149 passes. Antoine Savage gave the Sooners a spark just before half. His 81-yard kickoff return set up OU's first touchdown of the day.
20, 25, big hole, 30, 35, 40, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, and tackled inside the 20 at the 17. Placed in motion from right to left across the formation. Hibble fakes. Wild pass, touchdown Oklahoma, Trent Smith.
Hibble then found Curtis Fagan for the two-point conversion, and the Sooner deficit was just three at the break. Texas led 17-14 entering the fourth quarter, before Q did the Texas two-step all over the Longhorn defense, picking up a Will Peoples fumble at the two and stepping into the end zone.
Hibble looks down the middle, still looking, fires, caught, two-yard line. Fumble. Griffin picks it up.
That started another Oklahoma land run. First, Kewan Jones.
Kewan Jones right side. His touchdown, Oklahoma. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Great blocking.
Then Quentin Griffin. Q rushing for 248 yards, the second most by an OU player in the series. 35-24 the final. A third consecutive win over the Longhorns.
everybody in the room get it.
Next up was ninth-ranked Iowa State, marking the first of three consecutive appearances at Owen Field for Heisman Trophy hopefuls. The first to try their hands at the center defense was the Cyclone Seneca Wallace. This contest was no contest from the beginning. A minute seven into the game, Derek Strait blocked the ISU punt. Terrence Sims recovered the ball in the end zone, 7-0 Sooners. Wenton Griffin ran for 111 yards and two touchdowns. Kewan Jones ran for two more as the Sooners enjoyed a 35-0 lead at halftime. The OU defense limited Wallace to 1 of 12 passing in the first half, intercepting him twice, allowing Iowa State just two first downs and four total yards in the opening 30 minutes. Oklahoma outgained Iowa State 367 yards to just 60 and doubled ISU with 90 offensive plays to 45 for the Clones. Wallace finished the game 4 of 22 passing, completing four passes to his own receivers and three to OU defenders. A second straight top 10 win had the Sooners sitting at a perfect 7-0. In the Stoops era, the Sooners have scored 15 special teams touchdowns, including Terrence Sims' TD against Iowa State. It's something every coach talks about, but only a few have the proof the Sooners have. At Oklahoma, the Sooners put the special in special teams.
Wow, boy, he was nailed.
The Sooners next put an end to the Heisman hopes of Colorado running back Chris Brown. Oklahoma beat the Buffaloes for the first time in 9 games by shutting down 12th-ranked CU 27-11. The OUD again rising to the occasion by holding the nation's leading rusher well below his average. Early on, Lance Mitchell forces the Brown fumble. Derek Strait is there for the recovery. It didn't take Nate Hibble long to capitalize.
Throws a pass, caught the 2-1, touchdown Oklahoma. Savage makes the catch.
Savage becoming OU's all-time leader in receiving yards and finished his career tied with Trent Smith with 148 catches for the school record for career catches. Quentin Griffin winning the battle of two of the nation's best backs. Hughes sloshed his way through a game-long downpour for 128 yards on the ground, including a career-best 63-yarder that set up a Trey DiCarlo field goal. The OU defense forced 4 more turnovers, including one of Brandon Everidge's 6 interceptions of 2002.
Here's Hodge, 5-step drop, looks up, pressure for the pass, intercepts at the 22, to the 25-30, up the right side. Brandon Everidge to the 15, the 45-40, 35-30, Colorado 25-20, down to the 15. Brandon Everidge, he just threw it up for grabs, Robbie Hodge did, and Brandon Everidge right to him in a 63-yard return.
Trey DiCarlo was 16 of 22 on field goal attempts during his freshman year. His second of the game gave OU a 10-point advantage. The Sooners made it 17 when Nate hit the mark.
Blitz is on. Hibble fires the pass to the end zone. Clayton catches it for a touchdown. Oklahoma makes a touchdown and a great pass and a tremendous catch by Mark Clayton.
All-American linebacker Teddy Lehman gave OU some great field position in the third quarter, thanks to one of his 2 interceptions on the year. 2 plays later, Hibble found Clayton again.
Well, Hibble rolls to his left, fires in the end zone, has a man, and a save. Touchdown, Oklahoma!
A 16-point win over the Buffs, and a perfect 8-0 headed to College Station. The Sooners entered their contest with Texas A&M number 1 in the AP poll. Unfortunately, a crowd of 84,000, along with former President George Bush, would see a bit of history on this November day. This would mark the first time in 44 games an OU team had lost to an unranked team while being ranked number 1. Trey DiCarlo tied a school record with 4 field goals on the day. And Nate Hibble was solid again, finishing the day 20 of 34 passing for 249 yards and 2 touchdowns.
As a man, it's caught at the 42-40. 35-30, Fagan, 25-20, 15-10, 5, touchdown, Oklahoma. No flags on the play, a perfect pass by Hibble.
That tied things up at 20, but true freshman Reggie McNeil led the Aggies past the top-ranked Sooners, throwing for 191 yards and 4 touchdowns. 30-26, Texas A&M pulling the upset over the Sooners. Oklahoma responded the next week by blowing out Baylor in Waco, 49-9. OU's lead was just 7-3 in the second quarter, but then scored 42 unanswered points.
Okay, on third down play, the blitz is on. Quick screen pass caught by Griffin at the 38. Nice play. 35-30. Back to his right, the 25-20. Back to his left, the 15, the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Quentin Griffin's incredible. Double tight end. Pitch sweep to T1 Jones. Cut to the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Beautifully blocked that time.
Down, blitz is on. Abel maintains the school, throws a pass. It's caught by 7 to the 15 to the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
Man in motion under center is option play. Pitch to Griffin, sweeping right. Makes a cut at the 15 to the 10 to the 5. See you later, alligator. He's in for a touchdown. The turn, give to Griffin. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Standing up. The ball from 23, 6 yards to go. He's back to pass. He's being rushed. He throws the pass.
There
intercepted
is.
At the 25-30. He'll go all the way. 50, 45-40, straight, 30, 25-20, 15-10, 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
Strait's third career interception return for a touchdown gave the Sooners a 40-point win, setting up a Big 12 South winner-take-all showdown with Texas Tech. The game was close only until kickoff. OU took the opening kickoff and marched 70 yards in 10 plays, capped off by Kewan Jones.
And there's the turn. They get Kewan Jones blast down the middle, inside the five, down near the goal line, touchdown Oklahoma. What a run by Kewan Jones.
Q topped the century mark for the seventh consecutive game, gaining 207 on the ground and 27 more through the air. This 62-yarder put OU up 14-0.
Goes to 50. He's at the 25-40, 35-30, 25-20, 15 to the 10, to his left at the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma!
Tex Cliff Kingsbury found his Heisman hopes smashed at the hands of the center defense, which sacked Kingsbury seven times in the game. Tech managed just 12 yards on 12 offensive plays in the opening quarter, and the Sooner D didn't give up a single Red Raider first down.
Running back strike both sides to Kingsbury in the end zone. Good protection this time. There's plenty of time.
They just rushed three.
They just rushed three. Now he's in the end zone looking for someone to open up. Nobody opens up. They got it. For safety.
Stoops' troops turned a 25-0 halftime lead into a 46-0 lead thanks to a dominating quarter.
Yes.
He got it. The kick is blocked. It's in the end zone. Brandon Selby, touchdown, Oklahoma.
6 inches away, the turn, they give to Hugh, dives over the top, touchdown, Oklahoma. From wing left to the right, pitch sweep to right side, Griffin, needs a block, 3-yard line, 2-yard line, touchdown, Oklahoma, right side. Hits the snap, back to pass, look, Brandon Jones, he throws, and it's touchdown, Oklahoma. Great catch by Brandon Jones.
60-15 the final. The game and the Big 12 South title goes to the Sooners for the second time in 3 years. The Sooners rolled up 478 yards against the Red Raiders. It was the third time OU had scored at least 60 points in the Stoops era. For a team that prides itself with a dominating defense, the 2002 Sooners were known to be quite offensive.
Smith in motion. They give to Quentin Griffin down the middle. Gets away one time. He's at the 10. Makes it close to 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
What a run by Quentin Griffin. Holy cow, a beautiful run.
There's the snap on the money to Hibble. Good protection. Throws a pass.
Caught at the 2. The 1. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Savage makes the catch. He came uncovered, got away from his man, and Hibble failed him at the 4-yard line. He went in for the touchdown.
To the left, here is the hand.
handoff. Quentin Griffin up to the 40. Breaks a tackle. Get to the 45. He goes to the 50. He's at the 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15 to the 10. To his left at the 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Holy cow, what a run. What a run.
With their Big 12 championship game ticket already reserved, Oklahoma finished the regular season with the Bedlam battle with OSU. The Cowboys duo of Josh Fields and Rashawn Woods teamed up 12 times for 226 yards and 3 touchdowns, helping to build an OSU lead. Nate Hibble tossed 3 touchdown passes for OU, 2 to his teammate Trent Smith. And Quentin Griffin picked up 102 yards on the ground, becoming just the third Sooner to gain at least 100 yards in each conference game. 38-28, Oklahoma State pulling off the upset. Still, the Sooners were headed to Houston and the Big 12 championship game. Stoops' troops took the field inside Reliance Stadium in front of a partisan Sooner crowd. Their opponent, the Colorado Buffaloes, had spent the past 5 weeks asking for a rematch from the two teams' earlier meeting in Norman, a game in which the Sooners won by 16. The OU offense took control from the opening snap. Nate Hibble led the Sooners on a 13-play, 77-yard drive that he capped off by finding Trent Smith in the end zone. Oklahoma had the ball for 6.5 minutes and had a 7-0 lead. Hibble then found Mark Clayton, extending the lead to 13.
They did not blitz. Here is Hibble firing a pass in the end zone. Touchdown, Oklahoma! Mark Clayton, who caught 2 touchdown passes in the first meeting, catches a beautiful post pattern.
After Colorado got to within 6 in the third quarter, Quentin Griffin would decide this one himself.
Trent Rodda Griffin over the middle, 30, he'll go all the way, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown Oklahoma, no flags. I'm trying to get outside, gets by one man, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown Oklahoma. What a run by Quentin Griffin.
A well-deserved ride for Coach Stoops. 29-7, Oklahoma capturing the Big 12 title, Oklahoma's second title in 3 years, becoming the first Big 12 team to win multiple championships. Buffalo blowout assured OU of yet another January bowl game and a second BCS appearance in 3 years. The Sooners were headed to the Rose Bowl for the first time in school history. The granddaddy of them all proved to be just as special as advertised. Players and coaches spent a busy week in Southern California, juggling preparation for Pac-10 champ Washington State with fun in the sun at many different events. The first stop was a visit to The Tonight Show starring Jay Leno, where the players got a personal hello from the NBC star. From one star to another, the next day was off to Mickey's house in Disneyland and Disney's California Adventures. After a greeting from Mickey himself and a few of his favorite friends, he was off to enjoy some of the park's attractions. Oh!
is Jay Leno or Mickey?
I don't know. I think Mickey might have Jay Leno, man. But Jay Leno is a nice guy, and it's just great to be here and experience this.
You said that he thinks Mickey's the biggest celebrity, but everybody else thinks Jay Leno. What were you thinking?
That's what makes Q special, his simple brilliance, okay? Q realizes that Mickey is a worldwide phenomenon. Jay Leno's not, okay? So I gotta go with Q. But meeting Jay and hanging out with him was great.
The next day was a trip to the Laurie's Beef Bowl. The players and staff enjoyed a warm welcome and delicious prime rib. Redshirt freshman Brett Rail put down the most beef, finishing off 8 steaks. Washington State consumed more pounds than the Sooners. A few days later, Oklahoma proved they were leaner and faster than the Cougars when it counted. A few of the players, along with Coach Stoops, made a visit to the City of Hope Cancer Hospital while they were in California. The team signed autographs for the patients and put a whole lot of smiles on a whole lot of faces on the day. Coach and players even ventured into some patients' room, bringing OU gifts along the way, even signing a ball for a Husker fan turned Sooner fan.
I think it's one of our ways to just give back to the community and, you know, little kids. I know how I looked up to football players when I was a little kid, and I think it's great that we get the opportunity to come in and, you know, be a positive influence and, you know, just let them know that we really care about them and how they do.
The Sooners balanced all the extra activities of the week around preparing for their New Year's Day contest against Washington State in the 89th Rose Bowl. The Sooners practiced all week at Loyola Marymount University. And as the game drew closer, one could sense the team was focused. In their 36th bowl appearance of all time, the Sooners would be making their first ever appearance in the Granddaddy. 11-2 Oklahoma, champions of the Big 12, and 10-2 Washington State, Pac-10 champs, took the field in absolutely perfect conditions. It was the Sooners who were nearly perfect from the beginning. On the game's fourth play, Quentin Griffin introduced himself to the Cougar defenders.
Direct snap, the Q on the draw play, gets by one sacker, gets the 35, he's at the 40, 45, 50, 45, 40, 35, fumbles the ball, and it's out of bounds.
4 plays later, Trey DiCarlo put OU on the board with a 45-yard field goal. 3-0 Sooners. Washington State's talented quarterback Jason Gesser came into the contest hoping to pick apart the Sooners secondary. But Oklahoma's pass rush would get to Gesser 7 times on the day while intercepting him twice. Nate Hibble was spectacular in his final Sooner start. The senior from Georgia connecting with another Georgia senior, Antoine Savage, for a 30-yard gain. The two then hooked up again, extending the OU lead to 10.
He looks to pass. He throws in the end zone. Savage, touchdown, Oklahoma! 45 people, takes the 50, Perkins rather, he's to his left, 35, 30, 25, 20, that's to his left, he's at the 15, he's at the 10, 5, touchdown Oklahoma!
17-0 OU leading at half, holding Wazoo to just 4 first downs. Things continued to roll along in the second half. With President Boren directing the Pride of Oklahoma, the Oklahoma defense continued to direct Gesser to the ground. Nate Hibble put the finishing touches on his Rose Bowl MVP award by connecting with Curtis Fagan on a 9-yard touchdown pass. Hibble finished his career at OU by going 19 for 29 for 240 yards and 2 touchdowns. Dusty Dvorak would put an end to Gesser's day late in the game.
And the the ball is picked up.
Quentin Griffin would end his Sooner career with this 19-yard touchdown run. Hugh finishing with 144 yards on the ground. His 10th consecutive 100-yard rushing game, finishing his career second on OU's career rushing lists. The second-team All-American finished 2002 with 1,884 rushing yards, second only to the great Billy Sims. Oklahoma winning the 2003 Rose Bowl, knocking off Washington State 34-14, finishing the 2002 season with a record of 12-2, finishing 5th in the national polls.
Feel good, man. I mean, many people doubted before we got here. We just showed them we could do it. We came out and played hard, like we prepared to do all week, so it feels good to be on top right now.
Yeah, the defense, that's an all-around great performance by everybody, offense, defense, special teams. We just set a tone the whole game, and we went after it.
This is the part where winners like you, Ben, say we're going to Disneyland.
Man, we ought to have been to Disneyland, so I don't know what we're going to do.
How special this game was. Offense, defense, special teams, you guys
really did. It was great. I mean, the work we put in, you know, this week going up into the Rose Bowl and you know, those practices that we had before we came out here, I mean, it all paid off tonight. We wanted to come out here and, you know, send Q and Nate, all our seniors, out with a great win, and we did that tonight.
Yeah, Jason Gessner is a great player, and we knew we had to win a game. First off, we had to stop him and just get a lot of pressure on him. So that's what we tried to do our game, just create pressure whenever we could and just go out there and have fun.
We just wanted to go out there today and just have fun. You know, we worked hard all basically the whole month on Washington State, knew what they were going to run. We've seen a lot of film on them. You know, we just went out there and gave it all we got.
The way you guys played tonight, you take pride in it. You represented your program in a great way yourself. Big 12 Conference stands for a lot. This is a special night. All those trophies we've got in our trophy case at home, we don't have a Rose Bowl trophy, do we?
No.
We do not.
In Bob Stoops' 4 seasons as the Sooner head coach, his teams have gone 43-9, won 23 of 24 home games, won 2 Big 12 titles, and the 2000 National Championship. There have been 9 All-Americans in the last 4 years, including 3 first-teamers this season. Free safety Brandon Everidge, linebacker Teddy Lehman, and defensive tackle Tommy Harris, all earning first-team All-American status in 2002. And Bob Stoops was named the 2002 National Football Coaches of America Region 4 Co-Coach of the Year. The end of the Rose Bowl marked the end of a number of great careers at OU. These seniors had a huge hand in returning OU to a national power.
have to celebrate you, baby. I have to praise you like I should.
The 2002 Oklahoma Sooner football season will be remembered for some more Sooner magic, another Big 12 championship, and the school's first ever Rose Bowl trophy.
This has been a Sooner Vision presentation for the Sooner Sports Network in cooperation with Sooner Sports Properties.